In the previous video, we learned identifying objects that roll and objects that slide. In this video, we will see objects that roll and slide too. Chotu and Pinky have music class today. Chotu is learning to play the dholak and Pinky is learning to play the flute. Their music sir gave them some time to practice in between classes.
Chotu, I also want to play dholak. Please give it to me.
Pinky, this dholak is rolling.
Yes, Chotu, because this surface of the dholak is circular, that's why.
After some time, Pinky looked at another dholak.
Hey, Chotu, just see, we can also slide this dholak.
Yes, Pinky, you are right. This means that dholak is round from one side and not round from the other side. The dholak will roll if it is on the round surface and the dholak will slide if it is on the surface which is not round.
This means we can roll the dholak as well as slide it.
You are right, Pinky. Come on. Now you play the flute and I will play the dholak.
So kids, did you see how a single object can slide as well as roll? After coming back from the music class, Chotu and Pinky started to see some other objects which can both slide as well as roll. We have some objects. Come on, let us see which of these objects roll and which of the objects slide. This is a glass ball. It can only roll because its surface is round. This is a box. It can only slide because none of its surface is round. Now let's see this tin box. It can slide because it has one surface which is not round. And it can also roll because it has a round surface also. And children, this is watermelon. It is round. It means it will roll. So kids, you saw that some objects can slide and even roll because some of their surfaces are round and some surfaces are not round. So kids, that was all for today. In this video, we learned about such objects which roll as well as slide. I hope you have understood this topic very well. Bye, children.